We're almost at the end of this lesson. In the next two lessons, we're going to talk about two main families of testing techniques: black box testing techniques and white box testing techniques. So what I want to do before getting to the discussion of the specific techniques in these families, I want to give you an overview of what black box testing and white box testing are. Black box testing is the kind of testing in which we consider the software as a closed box. That's why it's called black box. So we don't look inside the software. We don't want to look at the code. We're just going to look at the description of the software. So this is the testing that is based on a description of the software, which is what we normally call a specification for the software. And what black box testing tries to do is to cover as much specified behavior as possible. And the main limitation of black box testing, and the reason why it is complementary to white box testing, is that it can't reveal faults due to implementation details. Conversely, white box testing is the kind of testing that looks inside the box, so looks at the code and how the code is written, and uses this information to perform the testing. So white box testing is based on the code. Its goal is to cover as much coded behavior, in this case, as possible. And its limitation is that, unlike black box testing, it can't reveal errors due to missing paths, where missing paths are part of a software specification that are not implemented. And the reason why it cannot reveal them is because it is focused on the code and not on the specification.